Name's Buddy. Gonna show y'all today how to make a eclipse projector. Now, if you don't
projector,
know, you're the cameraman. You ain't supposed to talk.
I'm not a man.
You're the camera person. You're not supposed to talk.
Now, why not?
If you don't use one of these projectors, you could burn holes in your retina if you look at this eclipse, which is coming up
Monday
at around 2:30. You can't even look at it for a second. Look at it for a second, could be blind the rest of your life. So I'm going to show you how to make one of these projectors. It's pretty simple. I already made 4, 5, or 6 of them. I'm thinking about putting them on eBay. I believe I could make a killing. Anyway, you need a knife, one of these. You need tape. All I got's black tape because somebody won't find me the other tape. You need a piece of tinfoil about this big. You need one of these pins. I have no idea how this is going to work because I have never done it. And you need a box. All right, you start by opening your knife. And you cut a hole. Are you watching? You cut a hole about a half inch to an inch from the side. Then you litter.
On your own property.
On the other side, you do the same thing. You cut your hole. Oh, man, that's a good one. Did you see that fall in there? That was not supposed to fall in there.
Well, it did.
Your box should look something like this when you're done. Now, you take your tinfoil. Are you watching this? And you put it over top of one of these holes. And you tape it. All four sides. Once again, like I said, I got electrical tape, which I'm sure it'll work. Your tinfoil don't need to be wrinkled either. If your tinfoil is wrinkled, it could distort the image. Mine's pretty wrinkled, so. And you want to try to keep it tight when you put it down there. Keep it as tight as you can. Tape all four sides of it. Are you getting this?
Yes. You don't have to ask.
You could have a full-time job at this for a long
time. Yeah.
Right. It should look like this. Then, somehow you take this pen. I'm going to bend it out of proportion. You poke one little hole in the middle. There's no way that's going to work. You see that little hole?
Yeah.
There's no way that's going to work.
It might.
There's no way. Alright, then. How did that fall?
What?
Hang on.
Did you drop the pen in there?
Oh, my dang lid's messed up. Dang. Dang. Well, hang on a minute. Okay. I'm going to take this lid on the outside because it keeps falling in the inside, messing my screen up pretty bad. I'm going to go find some sun. Y'all sit right here. No. You need to come with me. Right.
I'm coming.
Wow. There's no way that works. Okay. Yeah. All right. Here's what you do. You take this little viewer right here, okay? If the sun's up there, don't want the camera up there because you'll blind somebody. You need to have it on me, not the box.
It is on you.
If the sun's up there, you're actually going to be looking down, so you're actually looking the opposite way the sun is pointing. Now, so I'm going to find the sun. There it is. Okay, I can't see over there. Then you're going to look down in this hole, and you're going to go until you see the dot. When you see the dot, that's what you're going to be watching. That's amazing. And you can actually see a projection. I made that fun. You got to check this out, baby. All right. You see that little dot right down there? I don't know if I can see it or not. Oh, I had it covered up. There's a little dot down there. That's what you're looking at. See, I can move it around. That's pretty awesome. But when you hold your eye over it, you'll actually watch the image of the moon passing in front of the sun. Anyway, I got about 4 more of these to make. But that's how to make an eclipse viewer. She'll look just like that when it's finished. Make sure you got all the holes on the outside taped up because you don't want no extra light coming in. Or just find you a black box. That's what I'm going to do. I said, buddy, I'm going to go up here and make some more of these things. I'll see you. Bye now.